Today we will discuss in this lecture introduction of alkanes, IUPAC nomenclature of branched and unbranched alkanes. Alkanes are the simplest organic compounds made of carbon and hydrogen only. They have the general formula CnH2n+2, where n is 1, 2, 3, etcetera. Hydrocarbon chains, where all the bonds between carbons are single bonds. Each carbon is again bonded to enough hydrogen atoms to 5 maximum covalence of 4. The carbon skeleton of alkanes is fully saturated, so also called saturated hydrocarbons. Sometimes these are also called paraffins. In Latin word, param affinis means little affinity. The simplest alkane is methane, which has been known for a long time in the form of marsh gas, which is produced by bacterial decomposition of organic matter. Organic matter is that matter which contains carbon in itself under anaerobic conditions. Name uses the ending of alkanes is ane. They can be categorized as acyclic or cyclic. In acyclic alkanes, the molecular formula is CnH2n+2, where n is an integer and contain only linear and branched chain of carbon atoms. Cycloalkanes contains carbon joined in one or more rings, because their general formula is CnH2n. They have 2 fewer hydrogen atoms than an acyclic alkane with the same number of carbons. In this structure, we will study the molecular geometry of alkanes. The molecular structure of alkanes directly affects their physical and chemical characteristics. It is derived from the electron configuration of carbon, which has 4 valence electrons. The carbon atom in alkanes has always sp3 hybridized. That is to say that the valence electrons are said to be in 4 equivalent orbitals derived from the combination of the 1s orbital and the 3 2p orbitals. As in this figure, we will see that these s orbitals of hydrogen, means 4 hydrogens, are bonded with the p orbitals of carbon atom. These orbitals, which have identical energies, are arranged spatially in the form of a tetrahedron. The angle of cos inverse is similar to 109.47 degree between them. And then we will discuss bond lengths and bond angles. By using these terminology, we can justify the geometry and shape and strength of organic molecule. So, an alkane molecule has only CH and CC bonds. The former results from the overlap of a sp3 orbital of carbon with the 1s orbital of a hydrogen. The latter by the overlap of 2 sp3 orbitals on different carbon atoms. The bond length for a CH bond is different than CC bond, means CH bond is 1.09 × 10⁻¹⁰ meter, and CC bond, the bond length is 1.54 × 10⁻¹⁰ meter. Here we are seeing that carbon and hydrogen bonding is less than carbon and carbon bonding, which define the shape and the strength of chemical molecule. Here we are seeing the special arrangement of the bonds, means these hydrogen atoms are combined with centrally by carbon atoms by the help of sigma bonds. Sigma bonds are saturated bonds and having and commonly found in saturated hydrocarbons. These 2 hydrogen atoms having the bond angle 109 degree. The special arrangement of the bonds is similar to that of the 4 sp3 orbitals. They are tetrahedrally arranged with an angle of 109.47 degree between them. Saturated formula that represent the bonds as being at right angles to one another, while both common and useful, do not correspond with the reality. Here we are having the common examples of alkanes which are saturated in origin. as for example methane. In this organic molecule, carbon is centrally bonded with four different hydrogens which are having sigma bond among them. Another example is propane, which is also a saturated hydrocarbon. These three carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 hydrogen atoms, which are sigma bonded. In this example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbon atoms bonded with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 hydrogen atoms with sigma bonds. IUPAC nomenclature of alkanes. IUPAC means International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. It is a setup by which we can give the nomenclature for alkanes, alkenes, alkynes and other organic molecules. In this nomenclature, we have the following points, that is, identify the longest chain, that is known as parent chain, number from the end closest to first branch, name the groups attached to the chain using the carbon number as the locator, designate where the group is attached to the parent chain and alphabetize substituents, use dry, tri, etcetera for multiples of same substituent, combine number and name of substituent with parent name separating with hyphen. If halogens and alkyl groups attached to parent chain, halogens get the preference in comparison to alkyl groups. So, the name of every organic molecule has three parts, as we are seeing in this structure. Here it is prefix, that is what and where are the substituents, then after parent chain, which is the longest carbon chain, and then suffix, ending with suffix, which is the functional group. The parent name indicates the number of carbons in the longest continuous chain. The suffix indicates what functional group is present, and the prefix tells us the identity, location and number of substituent attached to the carbon chain. So, first we will identify the longest chain. The number of carbons in the longest chain determines the base name, that is ethane hexane. Eth in this structure or in this formula is for using two carbons and N is the suffix. If there are two possible chains with the same number of carbons, use the chain with the most substituents. As in this structure, we are seeing that 8 atoms in the longest chain means carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4, carbon 5, carbon 6, carbon 7 and carbon 8. So, it is to be known as parent chain. And in this structure, we are seeing that there are 7 carbon atoms arranged in parent chain, that is carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4, carbon 5, carbon 6 and carbon 7. Here we are having the different structure which is branched, that is carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4, carbon 5, carbon 6, carbon 7. Here in this structure, there are 7 carbon atoms, rather at carbon atom number 3, there are 2 methyl group attached, and carbon number 4, there is another branch chain. Hence, we are taking only CH3, CH2, C, CH, CH, which is further attached by methyl group, and CH2 and CH3. So, this is the longest chain which has been selected for the nomenclature of alkanes. Start at the end closest to the first attached group means we are having Cl means halogen group, then we will start chloro or bromo or fluoro, and then end with N, that is end with the parent chain means ethane or methane or butane, whatever else. If two substituents are equidistant, look for the next closest group. As we are seeing in this structure, this is carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4, carbon 5, carbon 6 and carbon 7. Here we are seeing that at carbon number 2 it is methyl group attached, and on carbon number 3 it is ethyl group attached. So, we have been selected the chain which is nearby the carbon atom at the locant 2. Here in this structure we are naming this 2 methyl butane, means carbon number 1, carbon number 2, 3 and 4. We have been selected from this side which is having methyl group at carbon number 2. Hence, the name is 2 methyl butane. In this structure we are seeing that carbon number 1, carbon number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 covers the longest chain, and this is to be taken as ethyl group, that is C2H5, means CH2CH3, and the name of this compound is 4 ethyl heptane, means this carbon atoms has to be taken as the ethyl group. Then we will identify the longest chain, find longest chain. Note that it does not matter if the chain is straight or it bends. In this structure we are focusing on straight chain, means these carbons are arranged in a straight chain and these carbons are bent. So, there is no effect of bending, means maximum carbon number we have to be selected as per our IUPAC nomenclature. Number from the end nearest the first substituent. In this structure we are focusing at the carbon number 3 and carbon number 4. As per the IUPAC nomenclature, we will select the carbon atom which is having the shortest number, that is 1, 2, 3, and not from this side, because here the locant, or you may say the alkyl group, is at carbon number 4, and from this side this is carbon number 3. So, we will select this side of chain, in it carbon number 1, carbon number 2 and carbon number 3 having methyl group and carbon number 4 having ethyl group. So, the name of this compound is 4 ethyl and 3 methyl heptane, because it is having 7 carbon atoms in itself. Then after we use dye with 2 substituents, means 2 substituents means both substituents are of same types, but located over different carbon atoms. Here in this structure we are seeing that carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4. So, carbon number 2 is having methyl group over it, and carbon number 3 is also having methyl group over it. So, we will use dye for the same groups. So, the name of this compound is 2,3-dimethylbutane, because it is having 4 carbon atoms, means carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3 and carbon 4. That is why the name is butane, because this compound is having single bonded sigma bonds, that is why it is using suffix ane. Number the parent chain so that the attached groups are on the lowest numbers. Here we are using 2 colors, one is green and another is red. So, green is the right way for this one, means methyl is on carbon number 2 of the parent chain. This is the carbon number 2. We have selected the chain towards this side, means carbon number 1, carbon number 2. Methyl is on carbon number 4 of the parent chain. If we are using methyl group from this side, that is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, that is the wrong explanation of the IUPAC rule. So, we will select the methyl group on carbon number 2. Name the attached groups. Carbon alkyl groups means methyl CH3 bond, ethyl CH3CH2, then propyl CH3CH2CH2. Designate where the group is attached to the parent chain, means use the number of the parent chain from step 2 to designate the location of the attached groups of the parent chain. Means here we are seeing that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 carbon atoms are bonded with sigma bonds. Here the second carbon atom is having 2 methyl. So, 2 is the integer number which is showing that the methyl group is attached at carbon number 2. Name the attached groups. For halogens we are using fluoro, then chloro, than bromo and iodo. Alphabetize the groups and assemble. As we know that there are various functional groups, but as per the rule of IUPAC nomenclature, we will assemble them as per the alphabetization. Means if there are two groups as chloro and fluoro, then we will select chloro previously, then after fluoro. The prefixes di, tri, tetra, etcetera used to designate several groups of the same kind. Prefixes are not considered when alphabetizing. Example, dimethyl is equal to M for alphabetizing and parent chain goes last. As we are seeing that there are two structures, one is of freon 11 and second one is of freon 12. As per the IUPAC nomenclature, the name of these compounds are 11 trichloro 1 fluoromethane and 11 dichloro 11 difluoromethane. In this structure, we are seeing that chloro has been assigned previously and followed by fluoro because C comes first in alphabetically order, then F. So, as in previous slide, we have discussed alphabetization of functional groups. Here we are seeing the order of priority, means between similar groups, the group lower alphabetically gets the lower number, means the priority of this functional group becomes lower than the another group. As in this structure, we are seeing that chloro and bromo located on same carbon atoms, means carbon 1, carbon 2, here carbon 1, carbon 2. So, location of these both functional groups are on second carbon atom from these sides. Now, we will select the priority. As bromo comes first in alphabetical order, so we will select the chain towards this side. So, the name of this compound is 2-bromo-4-chloropentane, means this chloro atom is located over fourth carbon atom and total number of carbon is 5, hence the name is pent and suffix ane is to be used. If halogens and alkyl groups attach to parent chains, halogens gets the preference in comparison to alkyl groups, because halogen groups are highly active than alkyl groups. So, we will select them as in the form of preference. So, in this structure, we are seeing that there are two groups, one is halogen group and another is alkyl group. We will start the nomenclature from this side, that is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4 and carbon number 5. So, the name of this compound is 2-chloro because halogen group is located over second carbon atom and 4-methyl, it is the fourth carbon atom which is having methyl group over it, pentane. Pent means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms and ane is to be used as suffix which comes at the end of the nomenclature. So, the IUPAC name of this compound is 2-chloro-4-methylpentane. As per IUPAC nomenclature, suffix to be used for parent chain as alkanes, all carbon-carbon single bonded parent chain end in ane. Say for example, we are having three alkanes, first is methane, second is ethane and third is propane. In first example, the molecular formula of this compound is CH4, means one carbon atom is bonded with these four different hydrogen atoms which are sigma bonded, and in ethane there are two carbon atoms which are bonded with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hydrogen atoms. And in this propane, there are three carbon atoms, that is first, second and third, bonded by different hydrogen atoms, that is hydrogen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, the molecular formula of propane is C3H8. When carbon becomes 3, then the prefix prop is to be used and ane is the suffix, as we know very well. As previously we have discussed about the substituent groups, so here it is the ending of substituents. The substituent groups attached with carbon chain ends with aryl. As CH3 ended by methyl, so aryl is to be used as suffix for substituents, and CH3 CH2 having ethyl, CH3 CH2 CH2 propyl. So, if we will see this structure, then we will find that this C2H5 is to be used as substituent group, and the name of this compound is 3-ethyl pentane, because carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4 and carbon number 5. So, parent chain of carbon atoms is having 5 carbon atoms, and suffix ane is to be used because it is of saturated hydrocarbon, and ethyl aryl is the suffix for this substituent group, which is circled in red color. The structure formula of the organic compounds to be used as per the IUPAC nomenclature, the bonds are between carbons in a parent chain and not hydrogens. As we are seeing in this structure formula, CH3CH CH3 CH2 CH2 CH3, this is the structure formula, and this is the second form of the structure formula, that is known as Lewis structure. In this, carbon carbon bond is taken as parent chain and not the hydrogens. So, we will start the structural classification. According to it, saturated hydrocarbons can be linear by the general formula CnH2n+2, where in the carbon atoms are joined in a snake like structure, then branched having the general formula CnH2n+2, where n is greater than 3, where in the carbon backbone splits off in one or more directions. Saturated hydrocarbons can be cyclic, having cyclic structure with the general formula CnH2n, where n is greater than 2, where in the carbon backbone is linked so as to form a loop. Here we are seeing the 10 linear alkanes. In this side of table, we are seeing the number of carbon atoms, the name and the molecular formula. So, when carbon number is 1, then we will use methane, that is CH4. Carbon number 2, we will use ethane C2H6. Carbon number 3, propane C3H8. Carbon number 4, butane C4H10. 5 carbons, pentane C5H12. 6 carbons, hexane C6H14. 7 carbons, heptane C7H16. 8 carbons, octane C8H18. 9 carbons, nonane, that is C9H20, and 10 carbons, decane C10H22. As we have seen that these are the linear alkanes from 1 to 10. So, we have nominated them hex for 6 carbon, hept for 7 carbon, oct for 8 carbon, and ane is to be used as suffix. In branched alkanes, simple branched alkanes often have a common name using a prefix to distinguish them from linear alkanes. For example, n-pentane, isopentane and neopentane. These alkanes totally distinguish from linear alkanes, because in isopentane, carbon atom joined by or bonded by another carbon atom, and as well as in neopentane. Comparison of nomenclature for 3 isomers of C5H12. As we are seeing that we have divided the compound in 3 categories, that is common name, IUPAC name and the structure. The common name of this C5H12 is n-pentane, and the IUPAC name is pentane, and the structure is carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4 and carbon 5. Because it is a normal chain, or you may say the parent chain without any branching. So, the common name is n-pentane. In this structure, we are seeing that this carbon chain, that is carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3 and carbon 4 is branched by this methyl group. So, the common name of this compound is isopentane and the IUPAC name is 2-methylbutane, because this is a alkyl group, this is an alkyl group known by methyl. And in this structure, we are seeing that 1, 2, 3 carbon atoms branched by or bonded by 2 different carbon atoms. So, total number of carbon atom is 5 and the common name for the same is neopentane and IUPAC name is 2,2-dimethylpropane, because these methyl groups are attached on similar carbon atom. Hence, we are using 2,2 for the same location and di for 2-methyl groups. Here we are having cyclic alkanes. So, called cyclic alkanes are in the technical sense not alkanes, but commonly these are known as cycloalkanes. They are hydrocarbons just like alkanes, but contain one or more rings. So, the simple cycloalkanes have a prefix cyclo to distinguish them from alkanes. Cycloalkanes are named as per their acyclic counterparts with respect to the number of carbon atoms. Example, cyclopentane C5H10 is a cycloalkane with 5 carbon atoms, just like pentane, that is C5H12, but they are joined up in a 5-membered ring. In a similar manner, propane and cyclopropane, butane and cyclobutane, hexane and cyclohexane, etcetera. We will see the difference or the arrangement of carbon atoms and hydrogen atoms in next figure. So, this is the cyclopropane having 3 carbon atoms, means carbon number 1, carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, which is having cyclic structure, and the molecular formula of this compound is C3H6. In this compound, we are having 4 carbon atoms, that is carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3 and carbon 4. So, naming is cyclobutane. Here, these black atoms showing the carbon atom and these white atoms showing the attached hydrogen atoms. So, total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 hydrogen atoms attached by 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms. Hence, the molecular formula is C4H8, and this is the shape of the organic molecule. Here we are having cyclopentane, cyclic structure having 5 different carbon atoms, that is carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4 or carbon 5. These 5 carbon atoms we are seeing in this structure are joined by different hydrogen atoms, means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, the molecular structure is cyclopentane and the molecular formula is C5H10. As well as in this example, we are saying this cyclohexane. Hex means 6 carbon atoms when in cyclic structure, as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the 6 carbon atoms joined together by sigma bonds and further bonded by different hydrogen atoms, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Total 12 different hydrogen atoms are joined by, or we may say bonded by, 6 carbon atoms. So, the molecular formula of this cyclic structure is C6H12, and this is the cyclic structure of the same molecule, and we are saying this cyclohexane. Alkanes have different isomers as per their formation. As for example, straight chain alkanes, an alkane that has all its carbon connected in a row, there is no branching, and another is branched chain alkanes, in it an alkane that has a branching connection of carbons. Here isomers these are the compounds with same molecular formula but different structures. As we are using the term isomers, this is iso means same, meros means forms. So, by combining isomeros, we are having the name isomers. According to it, the compounds with same molecular formula but different structures. Here we are having the structures of different compounds. As carbon number 1 joined by 4 hydrogens, it will give methane. Meth means one carbon atom, ane means that is the suffix which is to be used for alkanes. It is also a saturated hydrocarbon. This black atom is showing carbon atom, and these are the 4 different hydrogen atoms. Carbon number 2, or you may say the 2 carbon attached by 6 different hydrogen, gives the structure, or you may say the Lewis structure, carbon carbon hydrogen hydrogen. So, 2 carbons by the name eth, and ane is used as suffix. So, here in this structure we are seeing that these black atoms are showing different carbon atoms joined by sigma bonds, and these are the hydrogen atoms, that is 3 hydrogen attached by a carbon atom. So, the name of this organic molecule is ethane. There is only one possible way that the carbons in methane, ethane and propane can be arranged. In this structure, we are seeing that 3 different carbon atoms are bonded by these hydrogen atoms, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 1, 8. So, the molecular formula of this compound is C3H8. Here we are seeing that these black atoms are showing carbon atoms joined by these white atoms of different hydrogen. However, carbons in butane, that is C4H10, can be arranged in 2 ways. 4 carbons in a row, that is linear alkanes, or a branching, you may say the branched alkane. These 2 structures are 2 isomers for butane. In this structure, we are seeing that these 4 carbon atoms are joined by 10 hydrogen atoms having 2 different structures, that is straight chain structure and branched chain structure, as we have discussed earlier. So, this blue color is showing 4 carbon atoms in a straight chain, and this blue color is showing 4 carbon atoms in branched point. So, this carbon atom is branching by this another carbon atom, and we are saying this as branched chain structure. So, in the geometry, or you may say the structural formula, these are the carbon atoms 1, 2, 3, 4 joined by different hydrogen atoms, and this is the straight chain. And this structure is showing this carbon atom. This carbon atom is directly joined by this branched carbon atom, which is having 3 different carbon atoms, or we may say that it is the methyl group which is branching these carbon atoms in another way. So, viewers, in this lecture we have discussed the introduction of alkanes along with the IUPAC nomenclature. Because alkanes having sigma bonds among them, hence also these are known as saturated hydrocarbons. As for example, methane having molecular formula CH4, ethane having molecular formula C2H6, etcetera. Along with it, we have discussed geometry, bond angles, bond length and hybridization. Alkanes are sp3 hybridized, hence methane is having tetrahedral geometry. And in IUPAC nomenclature, we have discussed about longest parent chain, either it is branched or straight, and about substituent groups as per alphabetized order, halogens and substituents as per their priority, and a little bit about isomers. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the alkyl groups, types of carbon atoms, that is primary, secondary, tertiary, etcetera, isomerism in alkanes, source and method of formation with special reference to Wood's reaction, Kolbe reaction, Kore-Hauss reaction, and decarboxylation of carboxylic acids. Thank you.